This video is brought to you by Envato. Are you like me and love DaVinci Resolve for editing and grading, but don't really love Fusion? Or maybe you feel like you spent way too much time conquering After Effects to leave all of that behind. I'm Tom Graham for Envato Tuts Plus. I'm a professional post-production guy. And today in this video, I'm going to give you a real-world look at a Pro Resolve to After Effects round trip, which is something I've done on pretty much every project I've worked on since I switched over to cutting in Resolve. You probably want to do one of two things. One, you want your vision to move alongside your motion graphics, and two, you just want a motion graphics overlay. So let's get straight into it. So here in Resolve, you'll see that I've got a project lined up that's pretty much picture locked and is just waiting on some motion graphics flourishes to bring it to its final deliverable state. For the purpose of this video, we're going to look just at this intro section right here. So for option one, where we want to be able to move our vision alongside our graphics, these are the steps that I take. First off, you need to set your in and out points for just that section that you want to work on, i.e. the section that you're planning to bring into After Effects. You can do this by dragging the handles or hitting I and O on your keyboard with the playhead in the correct spot. I like I and O. Head on over to the Deliver tab and we want to focus over on the left here on our settings. Now, because I'm going to be manipulating this footage over in After Effects, I want to make sure I'm sending it the highest quality images possible, which is why I think you also need to make sure that your color grade is finalized in Resolve before you send this footage over to After Effects. Because if you do decide to tweak the color grade down the line, then you'll have to go over some of these steps again. And you know, you can save yourself time and not do that, but I digress. In your render settings over here to the left, I want you to slide the presets over until you hit the ProRes section. Select that. You want to render as a single clip. Now there is a world where you can do this as individual clips, but I think to save you the hassle of re-editing this sequence over in After Effects, just do it as a single clip from here. For the format, I want you to select QuickTime, codec is Apple ProRes, and the type is 4444. The benefits of 4444 over 422 is that it's got a much deeper bit depth and color sampling. Now it may not make much of a discernible difference, but the data is there, and we're trying to round trip this footage in the least destructive way possible. So just go ahead and opt for 4444. Set your resolution and frame rate. So if you plan on delivering your project in 4K, this is the time to set that export to 4K. And you can also select constant bitrate here. Again, maybe a little bit of overkill, but we do want this file to be as beefy as possible and not flimsy, which will just save us any trouble at the other end. All right, send it on over to the render queue and get rendering. In the meantime, let's go ahead and open up After Effects. So go ahead and open up a new project in After Effects, but instead of creating a new composition right now, I want you to drag your freshly rendered piece of footage from the file browser into your project window on the left here. Once it's in, you can then select it and drag it atop this little composition button down here, and voila, you've got yourself a composition that is the same resolution, frame rate, and length as your render from Resolve. Now it's time to make your motion graphics. All right, now I've created some motion graphics and this is how I've decided to add motion to this intro. And you can see that I have animated titles, lower thirds, some little flourishes, and importantly, I've added motion to the footage that we brought out of Resolve. All right, so now that we're happy with our motion sequence here, before we send it over to the render queue and then get it into Resolve, we need to make sure that our in and out points are still set correctly, which they will be if you've not played with them. But if you have, just make sure to set those again, and you can do that by dragging the in and out points like so. Now we need to make sure that the composition is either open down here or selected in the project window. And then we're going to go up to File, Export, and Add to Render Queue. Down here in the render queue, I want you to leave it on best settings, and on the dropdown next to high quality, I want you to select lossless. Again, we're going for beefy here. Set your output destination, hit render, and wait. Depending on how in-depth your composition is, you maybe want to go and get a coffee. Now, while that is rendering, it's probably a perfect time for me to tell you about Envato. With one subscription, you get unlimited downloads of millions of assets on this huge library, assets like video templates for After Effects and DaVinci Resolve. These templates and all the other assets that you can find on Envato really serve to speed up your workflow and get your creative ideas from A to B really quickly. Now, I think the best part about having an unlimited subscription to Envato for me is you can just jump back and forward between your project and Envato and iterate on those ideas as they pop into your head. Grab an asset, chuck it into your project, see what works. So go ahead and check out Envato right now. We'll leave a link down in the description below. Okay, let's get back to it though. So back in the edit tab of Resolve now, all you need to do is drag that freshly rendered composition from your file browser into the media pool. Then I want you to double click that file to bring it up in the preview window. Then click this button here to select the vision only and drag it down on top of your original footage. There are buttons and hotkeys that do this, but I find this kind of manual way of doing it offers just a little bit more control and less likelihood of a new sequence than dropping over the wrong track and wiping out some other part of your edit. For me, I just find it gives me a little bit more control. Also, I'm just dragging the vision down, not the audio. You don't need to round trip the audio here as it's already in Resolve, untouched and unblemished. And After Effects is known for many things, and handling audio well is certainly not one of them. So there you go, you now have that sequence in as high quality as we could manage, round tripping between the two programs, and it's back in the edit, ready for export out and delivery. Now the second option where we just want a motion graphics overlay is basically the same set of steps, but just with a couple of different turns along the way. So if you aren't going to move any of the footage and you just want an overlay like titles or lower thirds or things like that, and you want to time it with the footage that's in Resolve, when we initially export out of Resolve, here is what I want you to do. Instead of selecting ProRes 4444, you can just do a bog standard H.264 MP4 file and keep it at 1080p. The only thing that you really need to make sure is correct is the frame rate, or otherwise you'll end up having some mismatched timing with your animations. Send that to the render queue, then let's get that over into After Effects. Once again, once you're up to this step, it's essentially the same process. I even want you to create a composition based off the H.264 file like we did with the beefy ProRes one. This is just a quick way to get the composition length and frame rate correct. Once you do drag that file onto the new composition button, it will create the new composition. But if you're finishing in 4K, this is where you can set the desired resolution. And to do that, you need to right click here, select composition settings, and then you can change the resolution up here. So for the sake of this process, we're going to do that. So you can see that our little 1080p scratch file is dwarfed in our 4K composition, which is an easy fix. Just blow the scale up until it fits the frame. The beauty of this method is that we don't have to worry about the quality of the footage affecting our final edit, because it won't be leaving After Effects from this point on. All right, I've magicked my way back to the completed timeline for this method. And before you send it out to the render queue, I want you to turn off this base vision layer so that we're only seeing the overlay. And you can double check that by toggling the transparency grid on and off here, like you can see I'm doing with the button. And if you're seeing the grid, then you're doing it right. And if you are not seeing the grid and you're just seeing a solid color background, then you're not doing it right. So make sure that you're not seeing any solid color there, or that you haven't turned your base layer off. You want to see this transparency grid before you send it over to export. Once you've confirmed that, we can then send it over to the render queue like we did before. This time, instead of selecting lossless, you can select lossless or high quality with alpha, and it's the with alpha that's the important part here. 9 times out of 10, high quality will suffice for this method, but your mileage may vary. You can do lossless if you want. Select your output destination and send it off to cook. Back in Resolve now, we're going to do the exact same method as before. Drag our render into the media pool, double click to bring it into the preview window, drag just the vision down and pop that on a clear track above our footage. There you go, that's After Effects motion graphics in DaVinci Resolve, the round trip. Some other helpful tips for working this way is to make sure that you are pretty on top of your file naming conventions, especially your versioning numbers. This way, it's really easy to jump back and forward between the two programs, making incremental changes to your motion if you need to, and then just generating new exports and dropping them into your project in Resolve. Bit of a hassle, but you know what? That is just kind of how we have to work between programs like this. It's maybe not as integrated as Dynamic Link is between After Effects and Premiere Pro, but for anyone who has actually danced that dance, that's not always as straightforward as it seems like it should be. All right, until next time, happy round tripping.